MFP had come to our university. I'd never heard of MFP, didn't know what MFP was. They needed a volunteer to share a little bit about their research, and I said, hey, I'll go. And I got to do about a 5 or 7 minute snippet, and I'm introduced to this entire world of minority fellows. It was the first time I had seen an African-American female PsyD in that room, and I was already a second year doctoral student. And it blew my mind, because I was like, oh, so we do exist. Like, I have to meet her. I have to meet him. And who is that? Like, it was just this, where, and y'all are all together in this group. What is this group? I need to be a part of this group.
I feel like my identity as a future Latina psychologist has become stronger in being mentored by so many individuals that are passionate about serving marginalized communities. When I go back home, I just feel very empowered, and I feel like I'm not alone in this strong desire that I have of serving others.
Coming here and learning about issues, current issues that are facing ethnic racial minorities, and how it affects their mental health. And so I'm being trained on cutting edge evidence-based practices, but more importantly, I'm actually able to take that information back to people that are in my program. I really feel rejuvenated here. Like, I get inspired and I get ideas about how I can work with my clients better, how I can craft my research in more meaningful ways. I think that I've gotten what I wanted from this, and every session that I go to, I end up getting something that I didn't even know that I needed.
I think we all, as training advisory committee members, try to provide trainings that maybe we wish we had had. So real talk about entering things as an early career psychologist of perhaps an underrepresented group, and what to expect and how to negotiate, and just a lot of the practical parts that may not be a part of formal training.
But I feel like I'm coming full circle because I was mentored myself, and to be able to kind of bring back some of what I gained in the experience has been such a fulfilling experience for me.
When I've had the opportunity to speak to my mentor, it's been a really grounding experience. It's kind of helped me realize what I came into the field for, and which was to help people, and to help people within a specific population. And so a lot of times when I'm caught up with deadlines and trying to make meet the next expectation, when I have a chance to talk to my mentor, he's very good about focusing me back on, why are you here? What's the work that you want to do?
I am excited about PSY in the sense that now I have kind of turned this leaf in my program. I've completed all my coursework. I've defended, you know, I'm kind of at this last leg. So I'm really excited to learn more about early career. You know, what's next? I'm getting this question quite often. What are you going to do when you finish? And I'm like, I don't know. But I know PSY is going to help me figure that out. So I'm really excited for PSY to kind of put me in that next phase and that next step to prepare me for when I cross the stage and become Dr. AISHA, what happens, and how do I get there? And PSY's gonna set me up for that, so I'm extremely excited.
When I came to this journey to become a clinical psychologist, it wasn't like on a passing fancy. I really wanted to do something to help people. And so, you know, I just feel incredibly honored. I feel really, really honored. If I could say anything, like, this has only, like, lit the fire in me even more. So, yeah.